Hi everybody, I am winner of SIIM ACR Pneumothorax Challenge, and this is my presentation consisting of 7 parts. Okay, let's start with a little info about me. My name is Anwar, I am data scientist from Kazakhstan. I got my master's degree in computer science and applied mathematics from Moscow State University, and I also graduated from Yandex School of Data Analysis. Currently, I am an AI department team lead at BTS Digital. I am also creator of largest data science community in Kazakhstan. I am 14th in Kaggle overall ranking, but I had no medicine knowledge before this competition. Here, you can see the overview of main features of my solution, and now I am going to go into the details. Let's start with input data. For expanding dataset, I use aggressive augmentations. You can see the list of them on the left side of the slide. On the right side, you can see what happens to the source images after augmentations. Some augmentations indeed look aggressive, and some of them even looked like a disaster, but the final results prove they work. Another vital input data manipulation trick is sliding the sample rate. In the original dataset, the proportion of images with pneumothorax is 28%. But for the effective neural network training, I need to control this fraction, this proportion. That's why I take all of the images with pneumothoraxes, but sampled only a fraction of the images without pneumothoraxes for training set for each approach. Let's move on to the model I use. My model zoo consists of three architects: ResNet 34, ResNet 50, and ServiceNext 50. For each of them, I apply combo loss of binary cross entropy, dice, and focal loss with unique weights for each experiment. Main features of training process are learning and separate reducing over time. Also, I uptrain all models from corresponding beforehand trained models on lower resolution images. Post-processing stage for this competition might have been the crucial one to win. A lot of competitors use tricks I called doublet. Its main idea is to use two thresholds, one for the generalization of probabilities of pixel being pneumothorax, another one sets minimum required pneumothorax area. Let's look at the example. In both cases, we apply top score threshold first and then check if the sum is more than mean pneumo area. In the first case, it is, so we kept it. In the second example, the sum is less than mean pneumo area and we drop it, however there are two suspicious gray pixels. So if you use doublet, we cannot get a pneumothorax with area less than mean pneumo area. Moreover, top score threshold is used for classification and prediction task. To fix this, I introduce third parameter, bottom score threshold. This binarization threshold is responsible for prediction task. This way, top score threshold is only responsible for classification task. Let's look again on the second example. First, we apply top score threshold. Sum is more than mean pneumo area, therefore we classify image as having pneumothorax. After that, we apply relaxed bottom score threshold to make a final prediction. Talking about final prediction, here you can see best experiments, best appropriate threshold, and fact that for the final prediction, I use top 3 best checkpoints from each fault from each experiment. And here are the references on the materials I used. Thank you for your attention. Goodbye.